Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and today we will be making a little watercolor travel palette, and I will be focusing more on the palette itself and how to make an actual mixing area, actually more than one mixing area, and also how to make half pans if you don't have those in your country or if you don't have Amazon or stuff like that. If you want to see that, keep watching this video. The materials needed will be some sort of paper, any kind of paper actually, you can even use printing paper, any painting notebooks, anything. You will need some sort of a container. Here I have this metal button box that was made for thread and needle and buttons, basically sewing supplies. And yeah, it's good, it's metal, it's sturdy. What I have used in the past is this earphone box. I don't know if you can see, it actually says Samsung on the back because that was my earphones brand, and I would have glued my pans to the bottom. And as you can see, these two are not attached, and I used a little binder clip to keep them together while I was painting so I could hold them in one hand. So that's a little hack. I'm going to start by showing you how to make the mixing area, and for that you need a little piece of paper, normal paper, that fits in the lid of whatever container you have chosen. So we take the paper and some tape, normal clear office tape, nothing special, absolutely nothing special. And I start by layering them, one row over the other. If you have the large packaging tape that is clear, you can use that and it will be way easier, but I just have this, so I'm going to show you how to use this. Then we take scissors and cut. And we repeat, and you want these layers to overlap just a tiny little bit. Okay, and once we have finished one side, we are going to tape this off from the very top piece and flip it over. Okay. And now we are going to repeat the same exact process. So by doing so, we basically just made this little piece of paper waterproof, and what that means is now you are free to mix your colors on the surface. Now we are going to cut around this, just follow the lines. So now this piece right here is pretty much waterproof. To add more mixing areas to this little sheet of paper, what I do is I take a piece of tape, approximately the same length as my piece of paper. Now, I don't know, maybe I'm going to do half and half again. So I just tape the edge of this tape, then I bend it slightly and tape the other end. So I don't know if you can see, now I have this little divider right here, and I have one and two mixing areas, and I can add as many or as few as I want, and this is very handy for those of us who don't have a hot glue gun. I bought a little tube of watercolor, but I realized that none of the online art shops in my country have half pans. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take a concealer stick. You can use a lipstick, lip gloss, whatever you have, basically search for something that has a square or a rectangular shape. I have not used makeup in years, so I don't care. I'm taking a knife and I'm going to cut off approximately as much as an actual half bun, which is about a centimeter. And now I'm just going to cut this off. So here I cut the concealer stick cap off. Alternatively, you can use a perfume, lipstick, lip gloss. They all have similar caps. You can even use a marker. Another thing I found is this sort of drinking bottles. You can just tear this part off and use this as a little half pan for painting. And yes, it's quite useful. So right now the only thing left is to assemble, and like I said, I don't have a hot glue gun, and what I use instead is Brit glue, because this is made from starches, and after a while, once it solidifies, it's not like super glue that it's permanent. You can still remove it and readjust them, but it's very, very sturdy and it's going to hold quite nicely. And the same goes for the little palette. I'm just going to put some of this glue on the back and apply it pretty quickly. Okay. Yeah, this is pretty sturdy. As you can see, I have none of my colors moving around. You can probably put them horizontally, lengthwise, and add an extra row of half pans or full pans beneath them, so you can fit a maximum of 15 half pans in a box like this, which is a lot. In my previous one, you could fit up to 6, I believe. So yeah, this is quite an improvement. And best of all, it still fits in my pencil case, which is amazing. Like, I have my pencils, I have a fine liner, and this, some set of squares, this thing that I use to draw circles, some tape, a glue stick, I have some memory cards and USB flash drives, I have my brush, a white marker, and I still have a lot of room in this. I still can fit a lot of stuff. So that's it for this palette. Thank you for watching, and we'll see each other in the next video.